Usted puede engrandecer a su gigante, usted puede hacerlo pequeño. It's all up to you. Help me here. Ayúdeme, por favor. You like my pulpit? ¿Le gusta mi pulpit? Something new? Thank you. I did it all by myself. Actually, I just did the cross. Every one of us has giants. Cada uno de nosotros tenemos gigantes. I don't care who you are. There is a giant that has been assigned to your assignment. Hay un gigante que ha sido asignado a tu asignación que Dios te ha dado. Salvation is free. Getting to your purpose is not free. La salvación es gratis, pero tú llegar a tu propósito, eso no es gratis. You have to go through stuff. If Jesus had to go through stuff, we're going to go through stuff, because the same devil that he defeated is the same devil that's trying to mess with you. And all you have to do is remind him that he's already been defeated. That's all you have to do. Lo único que tenemos que hacer, mi hermano, es recordarle al diablo que ya está derrotado. And you have to remind him that you have the victory because of the cross. Tú tienes que recordarle que tú tienes la victoria por la cruz. Can I get an amen? So, I want to encourage you with this, because the enemy has been attacking him. We have been talking about the giant of fear. We talked about the giant of discouragement. We talked about the giant of doubt. Hablamos del gigante del temor, gigante del desánimo, gigante de la duda. But what I want to talk to you about is about this giant right here that has been attacking the church, and it's the giant of worry. El gigante de la preocupación. Can you be honest today? Because we're in church. Estamos en la iglesia. I know sometimes, even if it's church, sometimes you lie in church. But how many of you in here worry, have a tendency to worry? ¿Cuántos de aquí se preocupan? See, this is not only for adults, but this is, I mean, everybody worries. There's kids that worry. Sometimes kids worry that dad ever is going to come home, or the mom is going to come home. A veces los niños se preocupan si el papá o la mamá van a venir a la casa. Sometimes they worry whether there's going to be food or not in the house. Can I get an amen, somebody? Amen. So we, everybody, todos nos preocupamos. Cada uno, I don't care how many degrees you have, and I don't care how anointed you think you are. You worry. No importa qué tantas becas, qué tantos diplomas tengas, no importa qué tan educado o qué tan ungido seas, nos preocupamos. Help me. Hallelujah. Don't leave me by myself. And worry is something that the Lord told us constantly not to do. La preocupación es algo que Dios nos dijo constantemente que no hagamos. No te preocupes. No tengas miedo. No temas. Don't worry. Do not be afraid. Do not fear. Constantly. It's telling you. Constantemente te está diciendo. Why would he tell us that? ¿Por qué Dios nos diría o nos dice que no nos preocupemos? Why? ¿Por qué? Because he's on our side. Porque está de nuestro lado. Not only is he on our side, but he's with us. Está con nosotros. So he goes by and he tells you, listen, don't worry, don't fear. No te preocupes, no tengas miedo. And we do totally the opposite of what he's telling us not to do. Hacemos totalmente lo opuesto a lo que Dios nos está diciendo que no hagamos. He tells you not to worry, and what do? Nos dice Dios, no te preocupes. ¿Y qué es lo que hacemos? Nos preocupamos. Aleluya. These are some nice glasses. I'm not afraid of these glasses right here. Oh, they're nice. I look all perky and everything. Let me tell you something, there was a devil. Real quick. Worrying, listen, because I got some of this stuff from the internet, because I wanted to see what worry does to us and why God wanted us, kept on telling us not to worry. En busqué en la computadora acerca de la preocupación porque quería yo saber por qué Dios nos está diciendo tanto que no nos preocupáramos. Why? ¿Por qué? It has to be a reason. Tiene que haber una razón. Amen. Worrying can affect the body in ways that may surprise you. La preocupación afecta al cuerpo tuyo en maneras que te pueden sorprender. When worrying becomes excessive, cuando la preocupación se viene a ser excesiva, it can lead to feeling high anxiety. Anybody suffer with anxiety? ¿Alguien sufre con ansiedad? It comes from worrying. Don't be scared. Right. You're going to be set free today. Vas a ser libre en este día. Worrying can lead to high anxiety. La preocupación trae que estés, trae esa ansiedad. Y aún puede causar enfermedad física. It can cause physical illness. This is very powerful. Listen to this. Escucha esto. Excessive worrying or worrying may see anything or anyone as a potential threat. La preocupación hace que cualquier cosa o cualquier persona venga a ser una amenaza poderosa o potencial. Some of us, we worry for the smallest things. Muchos de nosotros nos preocupamos aún por las cosas más insignificantes, cosas que ni tienen. Que ni tienen por qué. You don't even have to worry about it, and you still worry about those things. Help me, somebody. It's very important. Worrying can affect your daily life so much that it may interfere, listen, with your appetite. La preocupación, aleluya, puede afectar tu vida diaria. Puede intervenir en tu apetito, lifestyle, tu estilo de vida, your habits, tus hábitos, your relationships, tus relaciones, sleep, el sueño. I have some of you that are still sleepy right now. I know you just think that you're in sueño. And most of all, your job performance. Tu trabajo. A veces no puedes trabajar bien. Maybe sometimes you cannot work right because you are too busy worrying. How many of us in here worry for our children? ¿Cuántos de ustedes se preocupan por sus hijos? You might not have children, but how many of you are worried for somebody else's children? Algunos dicen, no, quizás no tengan hijos, pero se preocupan por los hijos de alguien más. When you worry, worrying begins to mess with your mind. And worrying begins to tell your mind to see things that are not real. La preocupación empieza a hablarle a tu mente y empieza a decirle a tu mente que las cosas que no son reales. How many of you, and it goes with children and maybe your husband or your wife. But I was talking to my wife this week. Estaba hablando con mi esposa. And I was talking about how when you let your kid go somewhere, cuando tú dejas a tu hijo o a tu hija que vaya a un lugar, or maybe your wife goes somewhere, and they don't answer their phone. No contestan el teléfono. They don't come back when they said they're supposed to come back. No vienen cuando tienen que venir. How many of you, your mind begins to play tricks on you when you start worrying? Tu mente empieza a jugar contigo cuando te empiezas a preocupar. Because all of a sudden, worry painted a picture in your mind of your children either drowning, yep, in an accident, yep, pulled over, yep, in jail, yep, or in a hospital. Yep. Come on, help me, somebody. Yes. La preocupación empieza a pintar un panorama en tu vida de tus hijos que están en la cárcel o que un accidente. And none of the things, none of those pictures sure that the that worry put in your mind are true.
Yes.
But you're worried.
Yeah. Yes.
They're not answering. Maybe something happened. Quizás algo pasó. ¿Por qué no contesta el teléfono? We do that. When my wife, when my mother-in-law doesn't answer my wife's phone call, you know what we do? Head over to her house. Cuando mi suegra no contesta el teléfono, for whatever reason, por cualquier razón, nosotros vamos a chequear. Worry.
Yeah.
Why? Because all of a sudden, worry started painting a picture in our mind.
Yeah.
La preocupación empezó a pintar un panorama en nuestra vida. Se cayó mi suegra. She fell down.
Yeah.
Algo sucedió. Something happened. Are you understanding what I'm trying to tell you?
Yes.
And worry has become huge in our life. La preocupación es algo que se hace grande, enorme en nuestra vida. So worry causes us to see things or think things that are not real. La preocupación nos hace pensar o ver cosas que no son verdaderamente reales. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So worry, what happens is that when it comes, it begins to push. And you begin to feel uneasy or troubled. Te vienes a sentir incómodo o perturbado porque la preocupación te está haciendo. Worrying is doing these things to you. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. One of the things that you have to be very careful is that if we are not careful, the devil will cause us to worry beyond what is reasonable. Si no tenemos cuidado, el diablo nos hace que nos preocupemos más de lo que es razonable. En otras palabras, I'm not saying, you know, some of you might have a little bit of worry, but excessive worry, la preocupación, preocupación excesa, o que no le creas a Dios. Worrying, catch this, worrying is like a rocking chair. La preocupación es como una silla, de esa, ¿cómo se dice? Es como una mecedora. It's always in motion, but it never gets you anywhere. Siempre estás moviéndote. Una mecedora siempre te está moviendo, pero no te estás moviendo hacia ningún lado. You're still in the same spot. Estás en el mismo lugar. La preocupación viene a ser como esa mecedora. Muchos de ustedes están en el mismo lugar porque se están preocupando. You're in the same place because you're worried. You're not advancing. No estás avanzando. No estás llegando a lo que Dios tiene para ti.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So why do we struggle with it? ¿Por qué batallamos con él? And what good does it do? ¿Qué bueno nos hace a nosotros? La preocupación. Worry is the opposite of faith. La preocupación es lo opuesto a la fe. Can I get an amen, somebody? And it'll steal your peace. Physically wear you out. Te roba la paz. Aleluya. Te cansa físicamente la preocupación. Y nos hace que nos pongamos malos. Nos hace que nos enfermos. It causes us to get sick. Can I tell you something? This is very powerful. And you might want to tweet this. Esto es muy poderoso. Hallelujah. When we worry, cuando nosotros nos preocupamos, listen, we torment ourselves. Cuando nos preocupamos, nosotros mismos nos perturbamos o nos tormentamos nosotros mismos. That's good job, Pastor. You're doing good. You torment yourself, and listen to this. You're doing the devil's job. Estás haciendo el trabajo del diablo. I knew it was going to be good. Worry is caused by not trusting. La preocupación es causa de no confiar en Dios. When you worry, you're not trusting that He will do Cuando tú te preocupas, tú estás diciendo que no confías en que Dios haga lo que Dios dijo que iba a hacer.
So what you're saying is, God, I don't trust you can take care of this problem in this situation. So now I'm going to wear myself by thinking about how I can fix it. Dios, yo no creo que tú puedas con esta situación y este problema que yo tengo. Así es que yo me voy a preocupar y me voy a cansar y me voy a enfermar tratando de buscar la solución. You are trying to look for a solution that God already gave you. Estás tratando de buscar una solución a lo que Dios ya te dio. God already gave you the solution for your worry. And he said, trust me. Dios te dio la solución a tu preocupación. Y es, confía en mí. The Bible says, la Biblia dice, confía en Él y Él hará. Trust in Him, the Bible says, trust in Him and He will do. It doesn't say, trust in Him and you will do. He said, trust in Him and He will do. Dice, confía, no dice, confía en Él y tú harás. No, dice, confía en Él y Él hará. Can I get an amen, somebody?
Yes.
Oh my God, hallelujah. This is good.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So the problem is that too often we trust our own abilities. Muchas veces nosotros confiamos en nuestras propias habilidades. Believing that we can figure this thing out. Creyendo, yo puedo solucionar este problema. You think you can figure out that problem, and God will let you continue to figure. Some of you are struggling with the same problem because you're too busy figuring it out on your own. Muchos de ustedes están batallando con ese mismo problema por años. ¿Sabe por qué? Porque ustedes están tratando de figurar ese problema solos y no están dejando a Dios que venga y lo haga. You are not letting God or allowing God to come in and take care of that problem. So after we worry and after we exhaust ourselves in trying to worry, can I tell you something? You always, always come out short. I got nothing against short people, but you'll come out short. Después de que usted se preocupa y se enferma y trata de solucionar el problema, sabe que siempre va a quedar corto. Because God, there's things that God told you that He was going to take care of. Hay cosas que Dios le dijo a usted, mi hermano, mi hermana, que usted tenía que dejarlo, que usted tenía que confiar en Dios. Can I get an amen? So, Pastor, what do we have to do? Pastor, ¿qué es lo que tenemos que hacer? Go with me to 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. Primera de Pedro, capítulo 5, versículos 6 y 7. The first thing that we have to do is that we have to cast our cares upon Him. Why? Because He cares for you. La primera cosa que tenemos que hacer, mi hermano, es dejar traer todas nuestras cargas, nuestras ansiedades y traérselas a Dios. ¿Por qué? Porque a Dios le preocupa de ti. Dios se interesa por ti. God is interested in your well-being. Can I get an amen? So 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 6 says, humble yourselves therefore under the mighty hand of God so that He may exalt you in due time.
Yeah.
Casting all your cares upon Him because He cares about you. Can you put it in Spanish? Hallelujah. Dice, humillados pues bajo la poderosa mano de Dios para que Él os ensalce cuando fuere tiempo. Dice, echando toda vuestra solicitud o ansiedad sobre Él, porque Él tiene cuidado de vosotros. Casting all your cares, casting all your worries. I think it's the Amplified Bible says, all your anxieties, all your worries, all your concerns, all at once,
give them to him. Otra versión de la Biblia dice, todas tus ansiedades, todas tus preocupaciones, todo aquello que te concierne, dice todo, al mismo tiempo, dáselo a Dios. Porque Dios cuida de ti. Can I get an amen from that? So listen, some of us, we spend all day, all week, worrying. You worry about stuff that don't even pertain to you. A veces nos preocupamos por cosas que ni nos pertenecen a nosotros. Can I get an amen, somebody? We worry too much. We do a lot of worrying. And I said last week, or the week before, we do a lot of praying, a lot of thinking and not enough praying. And we do a lot of worrying and not enough praying. Mucha preocupación y nada de oración. Can I get an amen? So, let me just show you a demonstration. Pues una demostración, ¿cómo que? Let's say this is a representation of you. Él es una representación de ti. Every one of you. Every one of you. Cada uno de ustedes. This is serious. Okay? But I want you to get this. Quiero que tomes esto. Esto es en serio. It might look funny, but this is the truth. So I got him because he's a little bit strong, you know, he looks strong. Se mira un poquito fuerte. But we all said that we worry, right? Todos nos preocupamos. My question to you is, what is your biggest worry? ¿Cuál es tu preocupación más grande? Talk to me. Kids. Las finanzas, los hijos. What else? Relaciones. Bills. Okay, let's say, because not everybody has kids, let's say finances will probably be your big, one of your big, and between finances and children, entre las finanzas y los hijos, quizás son tus preocupaciones más grandes, ¿verdad?
Yep.
So I'm going to ask Brother Saul to come, because he's a little bit, you know, bigger. Not like that, you know. You wait till the last TV show. Okay. So he's a representation of your biggest worry. Él es uno de las él es la preocupación más grande que tú tienes. Whatever it is, whether it is children or finances. He's gonna represent that big worry. So I want you to come here, brother. Forward. I want you just to put your weight on there. Yes. Put your weight a little bit more. Have you weighed on there? Okay, what is your second biggest worry? ¿Cuál es tu segunda preocupación más grande? Anybody? Relaciones? Matrimonio?
Yeah.
Come here, Brother Joe. I'll keep you awake. I don't put you to work, I'll keep you awake. So this is, he represents your second biggest worry. Él representa tu preocupación segunda. Right? Yep. I will hold him. Okay. Put your weight on him also. But I want you to put your weight on him. What's your third biggest worry? Let's say he's your finances or your children.
Yeah.
And he's your finances. Right? Now, let's say you worry about your bills. Bills is one of the biggest ones. Los biles son uno de los más grandes. Los biles. Some of you are struggling right now, but Brother John, come here, Brother John. Brother John, it's okay. Did you see his face? That's your face. Go with it. Just go with it. You're not supposed to talk, okay? You're not supposed to talk. So he represents what?
Bills.
Mr. Bill, right here. I want you to put your weight on him. There you go. Like all you. So let's say, you know, you have finances, you have your children, you have your bills. How many of you are worried for somebody else's kids? ¿Cuántos de ustedes se preocupan por los hijos de alguien más? Maybe your sister's kids? Los hijos de tu hija, de tu. So let's get somebody. Who?
Sus kids.
Thank you. If he was me, I'll have everybody over here on top of him. Come here, Brother David. Brother David is going to represent somebody else's kids. Él va a representar a los hijos de alguien más. Thank you, Father. Just come on, stop putting your weight on him. All of you, stop putting your weight on him. Are you trying to see what I'm trying to do?
Yeah.
Try to walk a little bit, Josh. Try to walk a little bit. Come on, put. Come on, guys. I know he can't drag me one of these. ¿Sí están viendo lo que está?
Yes.
So, yeah. every day, you walk with all of this in your life. Todos los días, tú caminas con esto en tu vida. Now, how many of y'all worry for the most insignificant things? Las cosas más insignificantes that don't even, you know, matter. Que ni se preocupen, ni valen la pena. ¿Cuánto se preocupa por cosas que ni valen la pena? You still worry. Come here, Brother Rudy. Pastor Rudy. The smallest things. So the smallest things can get on top of you. You can get on top of you. Listen, I know this is plain, but keep them right there for a while. Keep them right there. I know this is plain, but this is a reality.
That's true, yeah.
Yo sé que esto está, quizás está jugando, pero esto es una realidad. Can I tell you why it's a reality? Because not only is the bills and your children and your household and your finances all over you, but listen, yeah. You are carrying stuff that you are not
That's
even
right,
supposed
Pastor.
To carry.
Yep.
Estás cargando cosas que ni deben de cargar. And I can probably come and put somebody else in here because some of you got about 1,000 things that you're worrying. You got things going through your mind and tu mente. Tienes cosas que están. I mean, you got 1,000 things going through your mind. Come on, somebody, help me out in here. Tienes como miles de cosas. You're struggling at work. They make your life miserable at work. Put that on top of here, right? ¿Qué hace la vida miserable en el trabajo? Aquí ponlo también. You worry about what you're going to cook. Put that on top of it.
Yes.
Not me.
You worry because what you're cooking, your husband likes it, but your kids don't like it.
Oh, well. No me.
Hey. If they don't like it, they're going to have to like it.
Yeah, that's right.
Right?
Yep.
That's what I say.
Because some of us make extra trips to the restaurant because my daughter don't like to eat there.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. It didn't go like that when we were young. That's not the way it worked when we were young. You don't like it, you don't eat. At some point, you are going to eat because you are going to get hungry.
Right?
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Are you see? Can you see yourself? Come on. Can you see yourself? You can't hardly see Josh.
Yep.
He's sweating. Está sudando. Muy apenas lo puedes ver. But I'm trying to give you a mental picture of your life. Quiero darte un panorama, una foto de tu vida. Él te representa a ti. This one right here in the middle, el del medio. He represents you. And this is you carrying every problem.
Yeah.
Cargando el problema. Jesus said, cast your cares on him. Right here, go to the cast your cares on him. Get up here in the front. You're so right here. You'll be okay. You'll survive. Cast your cares. Won't you rather live like this? Like this? Than all of this stuff? And maybe, listen, we can add some more things here. Podemos agregarle más cosas acá. Todo esto es preocupación. You know why God hasn't saved your children? It's because you haven't let them go. ¿Sabes por qué Dios no ha salvado a tus hijos? Porque tú no los has dejado ir. You know why God hasn't saved your husband? Because you haven't let him go. You know why God hasn't saved your wife? Because you haven't let him go. What do you mean let him go, Pastor? Just throw him to the curtain? No, that's not what I'm telling you. Pray to God about your children and just let them go. God, you got them.
Right.
And you know what your children did? Well, then God has them. I'm going to praise him and trust
that he has my children. Yo voy a adorarle a Dios y voy a confiar que Dios tiene a mis hijos. Because you were created not to worry, you were created to worship. Tú fuiste creado para adorar, no para preocuparte. So cast off, and he comes, Jesus comes back and says, why are you worrying? Look at the birds. Mira los pájaros. Ni se preocupan. Look at the grass of the field. It's a cotton. Ni se preocupa. You know who worries? Humans.
Yep.
Los humanos. Adam. He worried. He worried that God was going to find him when he sinned. And guess what? God found him. Adán se preocupó cuando pecó que Dios no lo encontrara y se escondía. Pero ¿sabe qué? Dios lo encontró. So why worry? Why don't you just cast everything upon him? You know why? He says, because he cares for you. He doesn't want you to walk around with all of this. He wants you to walk in because him whom the Son has set free is not in bondage, is free indeed. Porque aquel a quien el Padre ha hecho libre es libre, no atado. What? Come here. If God has set you free, si Dios te ha hecho libre, si Dios te ha hecho libre, why are you going back to get all the stuff that he already took from you?
Yeah.
Si Dios, if God already made you free, why are you going back? ¿Por qué está regresando a traer todo lo que Dios ya te dijo que te había quitado? How many of us in here has read that scripture that says, do not worry, anywhere in the Bible? ¿Cuántos han leído en la Biblia que dice, no te preocupes? Come on, let's be honest. Watch me. ¿Cuántos hemos leído que dice que no te preocupes? So why are you being disobedient? ¿Por qué estamos siendo desobedientes? ¿Por qué estamos siendo? See, you're right. Worrying is putting your trust on the enemy. La preocupación es poniéndole la confianza al enemigo. Some of us trust the enemy more than we do God. Muchos de nosotros le confiamos más al diablo que al enemigo. And I told you, the devil doesn't have to come in and mess with you because you're tearing yourself apart all by yourself.
Yeah.
El diablo no tiene que venir a perturbarte porque tú te estás perturbando solo.
That's right, Pastor. Right.
And you are imagining things that are not even real.
Yeah.
Te estás empezando a imaginar cosas que ni son reales. So he says, so why do you worry, little children? Still calls you a little child. Te dice todavía, niño, ¿por qué? Hijos, manada, ¿por qué se preocupan, hijos? Niños. ¿Por qué? See, it doesn't matter how anointed you are. It doesn't matter if you're a pastor. I'm a pastor and I worry. I'm here. I worry for you. I worry when you don't come to church. Me preocupo cuando no vienes a la iglesia.
You're right, Pastor.
I may not be talking to everybody, but I'm talking around here. It's going to be real. My mind. Mi mente. You know what? She probably went back again. ¿Se regresó otra vez?
No.
I know you did it, but my mind didn't tell me. That's true. She said, I didn't. But my mind didn't tell me that she didn't. My mind's telling me that she's gone out there again. You see? She can come in and stand here and tell me, I'll never go back. But when she's not here one or two days, my mind starts telling me, she's gone. You see how that plays in you? My wife told somebody yesterday, I can't remember who it was yesterday, that's why my husband has to come to pray at 5 o'clock in the morning every day. Well, that was my sister, right? Well, not my sister's sister. But it's true. ¿Por qué? Porque a veces como pastores nos preocupamos. Cuando las ovejas no vienen. You know what our biggest worry as pastors is? Is you not believing the word that comes out from that pulpit.
¿Sabe cuál es la nuestra preocupación como pastores más grande? Es que usted no cree la palabra que está saliendo de ese púlpito. Because if you would believe it, many of you would not be in the situation you're in. If you just put to work what's coming out of that pulpit. Si tú creyeras la palabra de Dios, muchos de ustedes no estuvieran en la situación en la cual están si solamente creyeran y pusieran por obra la palabra que sale detrás de ese púlpito. So we worry. So nos preocupamos a veces como pastores. ¿Por qué? Porque no. A veces le digo a mi esposa, ¿por qué la gente no agarra la palabra? I tell my wife, why do people not get the word? It's being preached. Está siendo predicada la palabra. ¿Por qué no la agarra? Why don't they get it? I preach on finances or relationship, or I preach on this, and then the next day they come with the same thing that I just preached. Were you not paying attention to what's coming out of me? Predico de un tema, y el siguiente día vienen con ese mismo problema. ¿Acaso no pusiste atención de lo que se estaba predicando? Help me, somebody. We worry. Nos preocupamos, and we don't have to. We have to turn the worry into trust. Cambiar la preocupación en confianza. God, these are your children. Sometimes I got, when I'm coming here, sometimes I have to come in front and say, God, these are your children. These are your children. A veces tengo que venir a orar a las 5 de la mañana y digo, Señor, estos son tus hijos. No son míos, son tuyos. And then he turns around and says, they're your children. Son tus hijos. It is because you decided to come back to Seguin that they are here. Porque tú decidiste regresar a Seguin, ellos están aquí ahora. So son tus hijos. God, but they're hard-headed sometimes. Anybody have a hard-headed kid? Come on. You have 6 of them? Lord, he's got 6 of them. Help them. Every one of us. Listen, all of our kids are not all, they don't all listen to us. We got some that are, man, you scratch your head and then you say, man, I think he came out on to, you know, the same as my side of the family. You know, sometimes when my kids do something, I tell my wife, man, they're your kids. And my wife says, no, they're your kids. Well, your side of the family. No, they're your side of the family. Well, yours are crazy. And then we just start talking back and forth. Yours are crazy. No, yours are. But regardless of what side of the family they came from, there's still a solution for this. And that is to cast your cares on you. Many of you, listen, turn around, just y'all get behind him. And cling to him. And grab a hold of him. Many of you, this is what you do, okay? Muchos de ustedes, esto es lo que hacen. I come up here, I finish preaching, acabo de predicar, and I say, how many of you want to be set free? ¿Cuántos quieren ser libres? 3 or 4 or 5 of you. Raise your hand, levanta su mano. Y le digo, vengan para acá. Come and leave everything at the altar. Vengan y dejen todo el altar. So you come to the altar. You come to the altar. And you leave everything here. Deja todo aquí. And I pray for you. Oro por ti. And you cry. Y lloras. And you cry. I mean, you even believe it yourself. Lloras tanto que aún tú misma te la crees. And I'm praying for you and I'm speaking to you. Estoy orando por ti. Y te digo, hermano, hermana, créale a Dios. Sister, believe God. Sí, pastor. Sí, yo le voy a... Yes. Le voy a creer a Dios por mi sanidad. I'm going to believe God for my healing. Then you just llore y llore. Mocos por donde quieras. Llore y llore. And I finish praying for you. Dejo de orar por ti. And then you pick everything back up. Levantas todo otra vez. Y te vas. I'm the one preaching something. Y'all are quiet. And I know I'm preaching something. What you were supposed to leave here, you didn't leave here. You took it back with you. And you're wondering why the prayer that the pastor made for you did not work. It is not that the pastor's prayer did not work. It's that you picked everything back up yourself and didn't live it here like you were supposed to. Te vas aquí pensando, ¿por qué la oración del pastor no trabajó? No tuvo efecto. No es que no tuvo efecto. Es
veces tú no creíste y levantaste a cada uno de los problemas que tenías y te los llevaste otra vez a tu casa. Come on, somebody, help me.
Amen.
I know it's a little bit hard, but I want to help you.
Yes.
Because when God says, bring everything to me, cast it, He wants you, when you leave from this house like that, He wants you to leave like that. Así quiere que tú te vayas. Now with this, let God take care of all of this. Deja que Dios se encargue de todo esto. Así te quiere Dios, libre para levantar tus manos, free to lift up your hands, free to worship without a care in the world, sin ninguna preocupación. Así te quiere Dios. This is how He created you. Así te creó. When He said He's looking for true worshipers, He's looking for true believers that will believe Him. Cuando dice que busca verdaderos adoradores, está buscando verdadera gente que le crea a Dios. That though the storms may come, I'm still going to worship you. Because I'm free. Yo soy libre. Cuando venga la tormenta, Padre, te voy a adorar porque yo soy libre. So I'm casting all my cares on you. And you turn around and you wait. You wait. You wait. Wait. Pay attention.
Hallelujah.
Really? Now, that doesn't mean that these things are not in your life, because they are. But they don't control you. No quiere decir que estas cosas no están en tu vida. Lo que quiere decir es que ellos no te controlan. Because when, because when violence things come, and as soon as they come,
God, they're yours.
God, they're yours. Tú te vas a encargar de mis finanzas.
What are you?
What?
Bills.
Yeah, you were bills. When the bills come, cuando vengan los bills, vienen y te quieren atormentar, they want to torment you. Lord, they're your bills.
Yep.
Son tus bills.
Yep.
When the children are acting up, or asleep in Joel's case. I miss him. He hasn't been here like in a year or so. I'm gonna be praying for both of your jobs. Yeah, they should be working on someday. Anyway, that's another story. But when your kids come and they're all acting up, tus hijos están portando mal, y vienen, vienen, vienen. Señor, these are your children. These are your children. I'm gonna put them in your hands. What are you? Other people's kids. Now, I'm not saying that you should care for them, but they ain't your kids. I mean, they are not your, and I'm not saying, yes, you are supposed to, but listen, if he comes with the social security number, grab a hold of him, yes. But if his social security number is still with his mom, you better take him back to his mom. Because if you're coming, income is coming with you. I'm going to claim you at the end of the year. You hear me? I'm not going to feed you for free. But when these kids are acting up, cuando los hijos empiezan a portar mal, y que vienen a querer, Señor, te lo doy a ti. And then when the things that are insignificant, I mean, cosas insignificantes, small things, short, cosas pequeñas, chaparritas, enanitas, small things, bald-headed things, I mean, cosas pelonas, they try to come at you, vienen a ti. Lord, they're yours. So, we have a hard time letting things go. You know why I've learned this and I've done this myself? It's because we don't trust. No confianza. And God, let me tell you something. Everybody, can I sit up? God, the one that told you not to worry, Dios, aquel que te dijo que no te preocupes, He created the heavens
creó los cielos, created the earth, creó la tierra. He created the stars, creó las estrellas. You look at every flower, you look at every bird. Tú miras cada flor, cada pájaro, in its design, the little details, in details, en detalles. Dios los creó. God created them. The one who parted the Red Sea, el que abrió el Mar Rojo. The one who fed the 5,000, el que le dio de comer a los 5,000. That God comes in and tells you not to worry. Why can't we trust him? Why don't we take him at his word? ¿Por qué no confiamos en Dios cuando nos dice que no nos preocupemos? ¿Por qué no tomamos la palabra? If something comes at you, cast it over to him. He said, because I care for you and you're not supposed to carry that. You're not designed to carry that weight. The only weight that you are supposed to carry is the glory of God. El único peso que usted y yo tenemos que cargar es el peso de la gloria de Dios. We are to be carriers of the glory. Cargadores de la gloria. But how can I be a carrier of the glory with all that mess on top of me? ¿Cómo puedo ser cargador, portador de la gloria de Dios con todo ese mugrero arriba de mí? So listen. Today, we are going to cast our cares on him. And he will give us rest. Some of you, y'all need to rest. Algunos de ustedes necesitan que descansar verdaderamente. Some of you, if you just not worry, you won't have that high blood pressure. You won't have those anxiety attacks. No tuvieras esos ataques de ansiedad o esa alta presión o ese azúcar si solamente dejaras de preocuparte. Pastor, I think the devil is attacking me. The devil ain't attacking me. It's you. You're worrying too much. Pastor, el diablo me está atacando. No es el diablo, eres tú mismo. Te estás preocupando. Y la preocupación trajo ansiedad. Y la ansiedad trajo enfermedad y alta presión y azúcar y todo esto. Y todo lo que tú quieras y sale y lo que quieras. Brought everything. Because when one sickness comes, it brings everything that it has. Cuando una enfermedad viene, trae todo lo que viene con esa enfermedad. And the enemy will come in and tell you you have this. And you start believing it. El enemigo viene y dice que tú tienes esto. I want you to stand to your feet right now. Quiero que te pongas de pie.